Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's the new year, and I'm here to talk about just some of the projects I'm going to be doing this year. There's people watching over there.
So, 2024, what we did. It's not far enough from civilization.
So if I had to break down 2023, a lot of its achievements are probably things that are behind the YouTube channel. The film Gnomes, as you know, got nominated by the ASC for Best Graduate Cinematography. It didn't win, but it got nominated, and this is like one of the most prestigious things. I know probably you as Godzilla fans don't even know what the hell I'm talking about. There's a lot of things that just went well last year with that film. It's out of the 23 or so film festivals I submitted to. So far, just in the past year, because there's more this year. So far in the past year, I won one in Athens, Greece, Best Horror. I won one in Tampa Bay, that's a city in Florida, for Best Escapism Film. I won People's Choice and Best Acting at my school's film festival. So it's been doing really well. I did not expect it to do this well in these film festivals, because it's this one thing to be selected, right? That's a very low chance for any film festival. Like, to be selected in a film festival is like 10%, 5% in any, even if they're small or big. So to actually win those film festivals too, that's a big honor, and I think it's something to be celebrated, in my opinion. But I also made, for my senior thesis, when I graduated college, I made a movie called Manhunt. It's a short film about a son who goes on a hunting trip with his father, who's very abusive psychologically and physically, and they go on a hunting trip looking for a deadly panther in the woods. Now, I can say this, it's probably one of my least proud of projects, because it's really more for the grade. I did it more for the grade. I didn't really want to do it. It could have been way better. Like, the story is weak, in my opinion. The characters are weak. The acting was really good. I had some people, I actually did some auditions through Facebook, and I've never done that before. Let me know in the comments, do you want to see this film or not? Because here's the thing, I'm not scared of showing stuff that I'm not proud of. I'm not one of those people who takes 10 years to make one damn movie because they're so insecure about how their work will look. Everyone's trying to be perfect with their movies. Nobody's perfect. I'm far from perfect. I don't care that people see the shitty things that I make, like Chino Field, Counterplay, that's one of the movies that I'm not proud of, but this is one of them where I just think it could have been way better if I just had more time to flesh out the story and the writing. The writing I'm not proud of. That's the biggest thing I want to work on in my movies, is writing. So as far as 2024, what am I gonna make? Is he gonna make Apex 2? No. I did joke about making a noir cut of Apex. I think I've joked about that twice now. So I don't know if I'm gonna do it. If I do it, count that as, I guess, one of the movies or versions of a movie coming out early 2024. I don't want to milk Apex. That's kind of a 50-50, so I don't promise that. What I will promise though is I am gonna start working on my next big project this year. Now, this is a project I've been like really thinking about since summer of 2023. Right after I finished Gnomes, around like April, I started getting into the idea of liminal spaces, which is very popular on YouTube. I want to do a take on it that's different than what other people have done with the idea of liminal spaces. So that is going to be the next project. I don't want to talk about anything in the film, but I've been getting a lot of ideas for the film, a lot of different things. I don't know if it's going to be a short film or a feature film. It could be any of the two. But I'm very excited about it, because I feel like this will be the most personal movie to me as a filmmaker. I'm making it for myself. A lot of what I do it for myself. I want to shoot in real locations. I also want to do a lot of things digitally with Chris, either in Blender or any other kind of digital softwares. I want to take my effects to the next level. If you saw Apex and you got those shots of Ghidorah flying in the clouds, this is going to look 10 times better than that. I am on my own journey. I feel like with YouTube, I've lived a lot most of my life, like I've said before in many videos on YouTube. And I feel like, yes, there's more juice to get out of YouTube, but I am focused on working on myself and my filmography, because that's why I'm living for. That's what I'm living for. I want to work on myself. I had some goals of 2023 that I believe were the wrong goals to be focusing on someone my age, someone who needs to be better financially and to finally move out of the house. That's one of my number one goals of the year, is to move out of my house, move out of this state, because I believe that wherever you are, once you're out of college or out of high school and you're not going to college, if you want to pursue something that is not around where you are, you need to get out of there, okay? Because all you're going to do is fall into the matrix of the 9-to-5 and you're going to stay there for the rest of your life. You need to plan accordingly, get out of that place and follow your dreams in a place where there is that dream. This year I'm working towards moving out and making my next film. I'm really passionate about this next film. I've been wanting to do it since last year, and I'm really moving forward with that. I'm going to begin writing it now. Right after the camera turns off, I'm going to start writing it. As far as other projects pertaining to the YouTube channel, like short films and such, pretend this fan film contest that's coming up is a film of its own, because I am taking it to the next level. There's a whole story going on. I know some of you guys don't like the plots I add in here, you just want to see the winners, but I'm going to be honest, I don't care. I have fun making these skits at the beginning of these contests, and it's going to be around the whole contest till beginning to end. I'm excited for this. It's insane. I'm excited to do that. I hopefully will get it out by the end of January or mid-February. I don't want to wait till April, like I've been pushing them back more and more. As far as Halloween projects, I do want to continue my horror series that I've been doing on my channel. I've gotten 2 episodes out. The reason I didn't continue directly off of Michael Myers is because it just didn't do well. And I'm going to be honest, I'm at the point where if I'm making a project because I want to make it for the channel, this is besides me for myself, right? I'm making my own films for myself. But if I'm making this project for the channel, it's not doing well, obviously I'm not going to continue it. I needed to get traction for me to continue it. So my plan is I was going to continue directly off of the second episode. I'm going to wait till Halloween to do that. I think it's a Halloween series and it should stay a Halloween series. But don't worry, it's not going to end. You just need to be patient on when it's going to come out, which is in the fall period. As far as other projects, so we got my next movie. I don't know if it's going to come out this year, the next big movie. But expect more episodes of that horror series, and this fan film contest is going to be like a movie of its own. Some short battles, possibly. I'm usually see that I do those in the summertime, so possibly in the summertime I might make another one. As far as growing the channel, see, there's a lot of opportunities to make what I call bullshit content on this channel, with stuff like Minus One or Godzilla X Kong, but I don't feel like doing that, you know? I'd rather make my vlogs and get no views off of them than do that, because I feel like that loses dignity. I would lose my dignity of what I've done on this channel. But I swear to you, I'm not gonna make the bullshit kind of content of just re-uploading clips by Legendary and get views off of that and call that a YouTube career. Oh, I do want to mention Five Nights at Freddy's. What could possibly be Five Nights at Freddy's in 2024? Well, I want to keep doing the clay stuff. That's a hobby I've been getting up and running again. If you've seen some of my posts, I made Withered Foxy. I revamped it. I may make a VHS analog horror with that Withered Foxy. I do want to continue some of the Apex Ghidorah analog series, because some people really like that idea and want me to keep pursuing it. So I may actually do more of that this year. YouTube is like another limb for me, so I'm never going to quit in the foreseeable future. It's always going to be something where I express myself in any kind of way, whether it's releasing a film, pouring my heart into something, or making a funny vlog, or destroying someone's fan film. That's just who I am. I feel like I'm someone who doesn't belong to any particular age range or generation. I feel like I don't fit with people of my generation or people of the older generation. I'm not one of those people that says I belong to be, I should have been born in the 70s. No, I feel like, I don't know, it's weird. I feel like I don't belong in any generation. I feel like I'm my own alien outside of everything. mostly because I feel like I don't fit in a lot of places because I am straight to who I am and I'm not going to change that. And a lot of people don't accept that or feel awkward about it, but I am who I am. I feel like with the horrible circumstance I've dealt with, issues just in my personal life, I believe now that at the end of the day, the only one who can truly save you is yourself. People can say things, people can help, but at the end of the day, no one's gonna pull you out of that pit. It's only yourself. And that's because the mind is the most powerful thing ever. It can put you in places that are inescapable, but if you can have a strong-willed mind to be able to pull you out of that hole, then that's something to be proud of, because a lot of people, unfortunately, don't have that and don't have the self-strength to get themselves out of horrible states of mind, you know? And it's scary. I feel like I've seen in that pit in the past few months, and it's horrible. There's a good reason our generation feels the way they are. It isn't something to be looked down upon or weak. And it's something in this world that's poisoning our minds. Who knows, that could be the internet. Who knows, that could be the isolation we put ourselves in with the distractions that we can find ourselves at home. Or it could be something else. I won't be completely dark about this subject, but I will say there is a lot of bad in this world, but there is a lot of good. It's just sometimes the good is hard to see when there's so much bad around you. But just keep digging and find that good, because trust me, it's out there. I know what it's like to be hurt a lot now. And it's a scary thing when you don't have anybody to turn to. So if you are going through a lot, guys, and you're looking for 2024 to be a positive year, don't be afraid to reach out to me and just talk about it, you know? Just simply letting loose steam can save you. So I'm looking forward to 2024. I have a lot of plans and I'm gonna start them right now. I have started them. So let me know what you're gonna do. It is damn nice to be out here, guys. I'm telling you, like, let me just show you about this.
It's nice and quiet, aside from the annoying tennis players. Over there, I shot a scene from my first Godzilla film.
Oh my.
I'm about to show you the place over there where I shot myself little chubby Kaijuzel 621 getting eaten by Machino. It was right there. I was like, oh my god, it's Machino. And over there is where I died. Over there, it's Wolfenstein running in 2016 horror series.
Are you gonna talk or are you gonna be stupid?
I shot a lot here. There was this head, styrofoam head called Emma from McJugger Nugget Psycho series. And I shot myself playing Emma the Eight Pages. Man, I've died a lot in this area. How many Kaijuzilla ghosts are here? And then over here, I did my Oscar-worthy acting.
I failed you.
When I broke those clay figures back in 2016. I feel like I'm walking in a trail of memories right now. This place is iconic to me.